Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I'm going to be showing you a simple way to make a cool website just like this in about 15 minutes no matter what your skill level is. So a few years ago, I created two similar videos that both have almost 500,000 views at this point. I decided to make this video because people are always asking for new updated tutorial guides, and I really think this is my simplest guide to follow yet. So before we jump in and start building the website, there's two quick things I want to go over and then we'll get right to it. Alright guys, so what I wanted to cover real quick is, what is a domain and what is website hosting? So a domain is basically the address of your website. Every website that exists has its own custom domain. So for example, google.com, facebook.com, amazon.com, those are all examples of domains. Now, what is website hosting? It's basically the physical location of your website on the internet, and its job is to store all the content that's on your website. Another way I like to explain this to people is by using this example. When you're building a website, you need to put it somewhere. So think about if you wanted to build a house. Before you can build it, you have to have the land to put it on. So try to imagine the house is your website and the land is your hosting. Okay guys, so what we're going to do first is jump over to my website so we can get the discount for the hosting and the free domain name. The link you want to go to is createwpsite.com/go. And there should be a clickable link at the bottom left of this video if you're on a desktop computer, but if you don't see it, just go to the description below and there's a link, or you can just type it in manually. And that's going to take you to the resources page, and then we're just going to click on this GoDaddy link. Alright, and now this video is going to cut to another video that I made earlier because I already have a GoDaddy account, but I didn't want to confuse anyone by skipping steps, so I decided to create a brand new GoDaddy account for this example so everything on our screens match throughout the whole building process. Alright, we're going to cut to that vid, and once it's finished, we'll continue. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is click the Get Started button, or you can click the Add to Cart button for the Economy package. They're both the same thing. Okay, and this is where you're going to choose your free domain name. So whatever you want your website to be called, you can type it in here to see if it's available. And since this is just an example, I'm going to use this domain. And okay, it's available. I'm going to hit select and continue. And if you try a domain and it's not available, don't worry. Just keep trying different ones and eventually you'll find something you like that's available. Okay, so this is the payment page, and we got the 1 year hosting and free domain. This is what your price should look like unless you chose to upgrade anything. Now we're just going to click here, click create account. Okay, and now we're just going to fill out this form right here, and some of the stuff is going to be blurred out from this point just for privacy reasons. And when you get down to the support pin part too, just put in four numbers that you recognize, and then you guys are also going to want to make note of all your account info too. Then we're going to click create account. Okay, and then I'm just going to continue filling out this form. Okay, and then once you guys have everything filled out, this all looks right, you can click save. Okay, and now I'm going to click PayPal. You guys can use whatever method you want to use. I'm just going to use PayPal for this. I'm going to click on authorize on PayPal. Okay, and then I'm just going to log into my PayPal account. Click log in. Okay, and then it'll take you back to this page right here, and you can just click complete purchase. Okay, now we're done with that. So you guys should be on a page that looks something like this. And now we're going to move on to the next steps, which is actually starting to build the website. Alright guys, so what we're going to do next is go back to GoDaddy.com, so we're on the home page, and then we're going to go up here and we're going to sign in if you're not signed in already. All right, then you're probably going to land on a page that looks something like this, but we're going to click the GoDaddy logo up here, and that'll take us back to the home page once again. Then we're going to click up here where it says your customer number or name. Then we're going to go over here to manage hosting. All right, and then we're going to come here and click these little buttons right there and click the setup button. And then it says select a domain from your account and find your domain and then click next. All right, and then wherever you're at, I'm just going to click North America because it says recommended. Wherever the recommended one is, just select that one. Then when it gets to this part, you want to click yes, let's do it. Okay, and then we're going to make a WordPress username and password. This can be whatever you want. Just make something up for a username and then just make a password and make note of it somewhere because this is how you're going to log into your WordPress site. Alright, and then after you fill that out, you can click the next button. And when it gets to this part, if you want this, you can get it. I'm just going to click the skip button. Alright, now everything's been successfully installed. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to click this no thanks button. And now we've successfully installed our website hosting and WordPress. Alright, and the next thing we're going to do is log into our WordPress account. So we're going to come over here to cPanel Admin and click this button. Okay, then we're going to come over here to your building tools and we're going to click WordPress. Now when this page comes up, just click no thanks. And then click OK. Alright, and after that, you should now be logged into WordPress, and this is what our dashboard looks like. Alright, and before we go any further, guys, I just want to mention something really quick that's important. Whenever you want to log into your actual WordPress account, so you're on your dashboard like we are now, this is what you want to go to. You want to go to whatever your domain is, and then you want to go to /wp-admin. And when you go there, it'll bring you to this page, and this is where you put in your username and password. Then you log in, and that'll bring you right back to your dashboard. Alright, so now we're going to start building the actual website, and the first thing we're going to do is install the WordPress theme. So we're going to go over here to Appearance, and then click on Themes. Then we're going to go over here, and we're going to click Add New Theme. Alright, and the theme we're going to be using is called Cubic, so we're going to go over here to the search box and type in Cubic. And there it is, and then we're going to click Install. Okay, and then after that's done, you're going to click Activate. Alright, so the theme has been activated, and the next thing we're going to do is add a title to our website. So we're going to go over here to Settings, and then we're going to click General. And this is where you can add or edit the title and the tagline of your site. So I'm going to edit mine, and you guys can do the same. Okay, and then once you're finished with that, you can scroll down and click Save Changes. Alright, now we've added our title and tagline, and if you guys can't think of a tagline, or you don't want one, you can just leave it blank. Alright, so now we can start putting up some content, because if you go over here and click Visit Site, you'll see that it's completely empty and boring, but we're going to change that. So back at the dashboard, and we're going to click on the Post section. And this is where you go anytime you want to add some new content. But before we do anything though, we're just going to get rid of the sample post. So I want you to click that box right there and then click Move to Trash. This is just the one that kind of comes stock with every WordPress installation so people can get an idea of what it looks like. And then after you have moved it to the trash, click Apply. and it's gone. So that's how you delete any post that you don't want anymore. Then we're going to click Add New up here so we can create our first post. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is choose what photo we want to use for our post's featured image. And basically what this means is whatever photo that we upload here, that will be the main image or the image that shows up on the homepage for this particular post. So we're just going to go over here and we're going to click on Set Featured Image. And then we're going to click Select Files. And I got a bunch of images right here, so I'm just going to select the first one. And you guys are going to want to put your own photos or content up, obviously. But I'll also show you guys, too, where you can get really good, high-quality stock photos like these for free in case you're doing more writing versus sharing photos. All right, then we're just going to come down here and click Set Featured Image. All right, now our featured image has now been set. And like I said earlier, if you're looking for really good quality free stock images, you can go over here and check out this site called Pexels, pexels.com. Everything is free. Just type in what you're looking for right here or click the browse up at the top and you should be able to find something. All right, and the next thing we're going to do is add a title to our post. So I'm just going to go up here and do that right now. Alright, and then down here, this is where you're going to put your text at, if you have any. And if you guys want to add a photo or any media within the actual post, you can just click this Add Media button right here. And basically, it's going to be just like your featured image. You do the same thing. You go, you select your file. Like this, I'm going to click this image. Same thing, insert to post. If you want to change the size, you can right here. I'm just going to leave it there. And then like that, you can see, and if you click this, like these right here, moves it over here, or over here, whatever side you want. If you want to center it, just like that, either way. But same thing with the video or anything else, that's how you insert any type of media. And then if you guys click this button right here, you can expand your toolbar a little bit and you can change your text color. And just this stuff up here is changing your font settings, bold, all that, align left, align center. If you guys want to insert a link to something, for example, say you wanted to take this and then... So now anytime somebody comes to your site and they click this right here, it would take them to google.com or wherever you want to send them. Then once you guys like the way the post looks, you can hit the publish post and it will be published. Alright, so this is what it's going to look like with one post. Now I'm going to go and I'm going to add some additional posts to fill it out a little bit more so we can get an idea of what the finished product is going to look like. Alright guys, so I just finished putting up the last post. And this is what it looks like. And then after you have about 9 posts, this is how your actual website is going to look. Very crisp and clean, and that's what I love about this theme that we use, and it's going to look good on your phone too. I actually just went and used Google's free mobile friendly test that they have and got a good response back. So you know if you send someone to your site, no matter what they're looking at it on, it's going to be easy for them to view and navigate. Alright, so that's it guys. Like I said, super simple, only a few minutes to set up. Now it's up to you to post your content and really bring your site to life. So thanks for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you have a question, leave me a comment and I'll try to get back to you right away. So I hope you guys enjoy your website and I'll catch you later.